everybody, my name is Karen and I am the counselor here at Plexus. Welcome to the workshop on the path to become a doctor. In this workshop, I will guide you through the steps that you are going to need to take if you're interested in a doctor career. And with that said, let's go ahead and get started. Let's start off with step one, which is the most common requirement. We have a high school diploma. Of course, you are going to need a high school diploma in order to advance into higher education. A high school diploma will make you eligible to apply to a higher education program towards your desired degree. In order for you to prepare for college coursework, high school students should take classes such as AP Biology, AP Chemistry, and AP Physics, as well as courses in math and English. Now, we say this because these courses can help you prepare for a medical career in college, especially classes such as the AP classes, since those do grant you with college credit. While in high school, students can begin shadowing physicians and volunteering in hospitals to show their interest in the medical field. Of course, you can do this while you are still in school, maybe even in summer breaks. You can look for volunteer opportunities or internships in hospital settings. Let's move on to step two. We have a bachelor's degree. Of course, you are going to need a bachelor's degree in order to advance to the next step. Many students who plan to apply to medical school will major in a life sciences such as biology, chemistry, or biochemistry because the pre-med courses are generally included in the coursework for these programs. It is important to note that pre-med or pre-medical is not a major. Pre-med is referring to the classes you need to take in order to get admitted into medical school, and that is why it is strongly recommended for you to pursue a major within the biological sciences such as biology, chemistry, or biochemistry. Some students interested in research or a certain area of medicine may choose a more specific major such as microbiology, pharmacology, or sports science. So that is, if you're interested in a specific area of medicine, then pursuing a major that is related to that specific area is a good idea as well. Other students may choose a seemingly unrelated major such as English, business, or engineering. So that is, maybe you want to integrate those pre-medical courses into another major that does not necessarily have to do with the biological sciences or natural sciences. For step three, we have take the Medical College Admissions Test, also known as the MCAT. You will need to take the MCAT in order to get admitted into medical school. According to the Association of American Medical Colleges, this is a standardized multiple choice examination created to help medical school admission offices assess your problem solving, critical thinking, and knowledge of natural behavioral and social science concepts, and is also a prerequisite to the study of medicine. Let's move on to step four. For step four, we have graduate from medical school. Of course, you are going to need to graduate from medical school if you want to become a doctor. Most students interested in medical school pursue their medical doctor, also known as MD, or the Doctor of Osteopathic Medicine, also known as the DO credentials, to work with patients and practice medicine. However, students could also obtain their MD in concurrence with another advanced degree to work in another area of medicine, such as the PhD. All right, we have reached the end of this workshop. Thank you everybody for sticking around. Before I leave, I'd like to let you all know to please download our Plexus app on the App Store or Google Play. If you download our app, you'll be able to receive instant notifications. We will also very much appreciate it if you leave us a rating and a review on the App Store or Google Play as well. We very much appreciate all the feedback you all can give us. Chat with my counselor if you have any questions regarding this workshop or you'd like to reach out about your journey to higher education. We're always happy to help in answering all of those questions as well. And finally, check out our Plexus YouTube page for more college readiness workshops. Our Plexus YouTube page is called Plexus Social Media. Thank you, everybody, again, and I'll see you all in the next workshop. Bye!